Hi everyone, welcome to Bruhan Mumbai Municipal Corporation's Virtual Training Center, and I am Mrs. Nehal Kodambe, your English teacher from VTC. Let's begin with today's session.
Welcome to today's session. In today's session, we are going to read and learn a moral story. The title of the story is Two Fables. Okay, there are two fables, but in today's session we are going to learn one between them. What are fables? First of all, we will try to know the meaning of this word. You can see here a cover page of a book, Aesop's Fables. So Aesop is a writer. We will know more about him. Who was Aesop and what type of fables has he written? So let's know more about it. First of all, we will try to know more about the word, meaning of the word fable. So fable is a very short story, usually with animal characters or even inanimate things that speak. What is the meaning of word fable? Is a short story. Fable is a short story, usually with animal characters. See, you on TV, you people watch many cartoon films or cartoon characters or cartoon programs. So in those programs, the animals, they do speak, right? So fables is also like them, a short story, usually with animal characters or even inanimate things that can speak. And a fable usually ends with a message or a moral. This is very important thing. A fable usually ends with a message or a moral. Through these stories, we always learn some of the other things. It tells you about the ways of the world and how one should behave in society. Through animal characters, this fable guides us how to live, or different ways of the living in this world, and how one should behave in society with the people in society, the people around us. So that is a short message is given to us by this fable. Fable ya asha type cha goshti astat ki jyachyamadhye probably animal characters चा वापर केला जातो. Animal characters बोलतात एकमेकांशी आणि या fables मधून आपल्याला काहीतरी संदेश दिला जातो. आपण moral story म्हणतो की नाही, त्याच्यातून आपण काहीतरी शिकत असतो. अशा गोष्टींना fable असं म्हटलं जातं. See here, the classic treasure of Aesop's fables. There is a cover page of a book, specially I have brought it for you, because in today's session, the story which we are going to learn is written by the Aesop. These two fables came from Aesop, the famous Greek storyteller. Aesop was the Greek storyteller, and his stories were told and retold in many countries according to their own local conditions. This is also a very important sentence. His stories were told and retold in many countries according to their own local conditions. They were being adapted as per their own local countries or their own traditions, their own local conditions. Here the story of the two friends and a bear is retold in English style. Okay, so there are two stories. One story is about two friends and a bear. There are two stories. Between them, we are going to learn the first one in today's session and the next one in next session. So you can see here the statue of Aesop. So who was Aesop? Aesop's fable, or the Aesopica, is a collection of fables credited to Aesop. He was a slave and a storyteller, as we have learned earlier. Believed to have lived in ancient Greece between 620 or 620 and 564 BC. So Aesop was the storyteller and he was a slave too. And his stories are very famous all over the world, and they are told and retold as per their language, as per the tradition, as per the condition of that particular country. And he was from Greece, and it is believed that he has lived in ancient Greece between 620 and 564 BC. Okay, so you can see here the statue of the Aesop, and his fables are very famous throughout the world. So, with today's story, the title of the story is The Two Friends and the Bear. Now, you must have read this story, you must have heard this story, you must have gone through this story. So, again, we are going to listen, read, and learn this story in today's session. Let's begin with the story. Once upon a time, two friends were traveling together through a wood. Wood means jungle, forest. You can see here. Once upon a time, two friends, note that word, they were friends. Two friends were traveling together through a wood. Now, while traveling, what happened? As they the forest, it is but natural, they will come across to some forest animals, and that happened. You can see there is a bear in the picture. When suddenly they came across a bear, a huge bear, you can see there. While they were traveling together through the wood, they suddenly came across a bear. They saw a huge bear were coming towards them. And as soon as their bear saw these two travelers, what did he do? The bear saw the travelers and rushed out upon them. When the bear saw these travelers and he rushed out upon them, rushed out, he moved forward towards them. Then what happened? You can see here how dreadful that bear is, and he is looking at those two travelers. Naturally, they got scared. When traveling through the forest, if any beast will come in front of you, it is but natural that we will get scared. So same thing happened with them, and then what did they do? One of the travelers was good at climbing trees. You can see in the picture. One of the travelers was good at climbing trees. He could climb trees as fast as he could. So, what did he do? You can see here in the picture. Without waiting for his friend, he caught hold of the branch of a nearby tree and hid himself among the leaves. You can see here in the picture that he didn't thought about his friend. And without waiting for his friend, he caught hold of the branch of a nearby tree. He climbed up a tree and he hid himself among the leaves. That is the past tense of hide. Without waiting for his friend, he caught hold of the branch of a nearby tree and hid himself among the leaves. He was so selfish. He didn't think what his friend will do. Though they were friends, he didn't think about his friend and he thought of his own self, and he climbed up a tree and he hid himself among the leaves. Now, what did that other one do? Seeing that one friend, he could climb well, so he climbed as fast as he can and hid himself among the leaves. But the other one, poor guy, he did not know how to climb the tree. So he did not know what to do. He had heard that bears do not bother with dead animals. But one thing was there, he was quite clever, and sometimes he had heard that bears do not bother with dead animals. एकाला जरा छान पैकी झाडावर चढता येत होतं, तो चढून बसून गेला वर. त्याने आपल्या मित्राचा विचार पण नाही केला, आपल्या मित्राला झाडावर चढता येत नाही तो काय करेल. पण जो दुसरा होता, आता त्याला मात्र आपला जीव वाचवायचा होता. बट ही डिड नॉट नो वॉट टू डू, त्याला पटकन कळलं नाही आपण काय करावं. बट वन्स ही हॅड हर्ड दॅट बेअर्स डू नॉट बॉदर विथ डेड ॲनिमल्स, त्याने हे ऐकलेलं होतं की बेअर्स जे असतात ते कधी मेलेल्या माणसांना खात नाहीत किंवा टच करत नाहीत किंवा त्यांना त्यांची ते फारशी काही दखल घेत नाहीत. ही हॅड हर्ड दॅट बेअर्स डू नॉट बॉदर विथ डेड ॲनिमल्स. सो सडनली वेन दॅट थॉट केम इन हिज माइंड, देन वॉट डीड ही डू? सो वॉट डीड ही डू? He threw himself flat down upon the ground with his face in the dust. He suddenly remembered that once he had heard that bears, they do not bother about the dead animals. So he threw himself flat down upon the ground with his face in the dust. You can see here. And then what happened? The bear, coming up to him, put its muzzle close to his ear and sniffed. That bear came near to him, close to him, and it put its muzzle close to his ear. The man was lying on the ground and it sniffed and sniffed. That bear came near to that man who was lying on the ground and put its muzzle, the face, the part of the face of an animal. It put its muzzle close to his ear and sniffed. He took deep breathing. He tried to sniff him. But what did that man do? What that man did? But the man lay very quietly on the ground and did not even breathe. That man laid very quietly on the ground and he laid in that way as if he is dead, and he even did not try to breathe himself. He just kept quietly on the ground and did not even breathe. He stopped his breathing also. Then what happened? At last, with a growl, it shook its head and slouched off. At last, what did that bear did? He growled, it shook its head and slouched off. He went away. He thought that man is dead, so he did not bother about that dead man, and it shook its head and went away. When the man who was sitting on the tree, when he saw that bear has went off, he has passed away, then that fellow came down and see here. Then the fellow in the tree came down to his comrade. Comrade means his friend, his companion, and he started laughing. And what did he say? He said, "What was it that Master Bruin whispered to you?" Master Bruin means Mr. Bear. We can say bear. Okay? So Master Bruin is Mr. Bear in that local language, in local English. So what was it that Master Bruin whispered to you? He asked him, "What did that brown bear whisper in your ear? What did it tell you?" Who asked the man who was sitting on the tree, who tried to escape from the bear's snatch and who never thought about his friend. And he thought he was so selfish that he thought of himself and he went away and hid behind the leaves of the trees. So then when he saw that the bear has gone, then he climbed down and he asked his friend that what did he say, what did it whisper to you, tujha kanat tyane kay sangitla. Then what did that man said, the other man who was lying on the ground, what did his answer? Just read his answer. Said, "He told me," said the other. He means bear. What that other person said? "He told me." What did he tell? "Never trust a friend who deserts you at a pinch. That bear has whispered in my ear." What did that bear whisper in my ear? "Never trust a friend who deserts you at a pinch." You should never trust a friend who leaves you in a critical condition or in critical situation, in an emergency. Instead of helping you, your friend left you alone. He climbed up on a tree and he tried to save his own life. So you should never trust a friend who deserts you at a pinch. Who deserts you means who leaves you in a critical situation, in critical condition. When you need the help of your friend, instead of helping, he went away and he just thought about himself. So take a lesson from this story that bear has told me, never trust a friend who deserts you at a pinch. So whenever you will be friendly with someone else or anybody, you should try to judge that fellow. How's the nature of that man? How's the nature of that boy or a girl? Whether he is trustworthy, and then only you should be friendly with that boy, girl or that person. तर तो म्हणाला त्याने माझ्या कानात असं सांगितलं की अशा माणसावर कधी विश्वास ठेवू नका की जो तुम्हाला मदतीच्या वेळेला, प्रसंगाच्या वेळेला, अडचणीच्या वेळेला तुमची हाक न ऐकता, तुम्हाला मदत न करता फक्त स्वतःचा विचार करतो, अशा माणसावर कधीही विश्वास ठेवू नका. नेवर ट्रस्ट अ फ्रेंड हू डेझर्ट्स यू ॲट अ पिंच, हू लिव्ज यू अँड हू रन्स अवे इन्स्टेड ऑफ हेल्पिंग यू. सो दॅट वॉज वॉर what he whispered in my ears. So that was the story of two friends and the bear. Let's learn new words from this story, that is a glossary. Glossary means alphabetically we will see the words and its meaning. So Bruin is an English folk term for brown bear. Master Bruin, okay, means bear. Comrade, friend or companion, comrade. Muzzle, as I told you earlier, the projecting part of the face of an animal. Wood, forest. Here wood means forest or jungle. Okay, wood means not only the wood, but here it is forest or jungle. There are phrases. To sniff means to inhale through the nose. The bear sniffed and sniffed. Okay, to rush upon means to move forward. The bear rushed upon them when he saw the travelers. To desert, to leave behind. To desert in a pinch means to leave behind. And the next word, at a pinch, in an emergency or when you need the help of your friend. So these are some new words and phrases. You can read and reread and you can try to know more new words meaning from this story. So there are some activities I have brought it for you. Just read them one by one. First question you will try to answer after watching the video is that, did the bear really whisper to the traveler? Did the bear really whisper to the traveler? Yes or no? What did you think about this? You can write it in your own words. Did the bear really whisper to the traveler? Next question. What is the moral of the story? You have to write here the moral of the story. Ha goshti madhun tumhala kay shikayla milalo? What is the moral of the story? And the next question is, use the phrases in your own sentences. You can frame your own sentences with using the phrases. I have shown you some phrases with their meanings. Okay, you watch this video, you rewatch it, you watch it again and again. Story is very simple. You know this story. You read the story from the book also, and then you watch this video again and again. You find out the new words, then you find out the meanings of those words. You read the phrases which I have shown you in the previous slide. Then you read the meaning of those phrases and try to frame your own sentences with the help of those phrases. Okay. So this was the story which is written by Aesop. Between those two fables we have learned. We have read one fable in today's session. We will be reading the next story in next session. So you keep watching the video and do these activities. Okay, so see you in next session.
That's all for today. So you will revise whatever we have learned in today's session. Please subscribe the channel and press the notification button to get the link of next video. Bye-bye.